Very few people in New York knew who John Zuccotti was. Didn't even know there was a park named for him called Zuccotti Park. But 7 years ago, something very special happened in this area. Was it messy? You bet. Was it eclectic? You bet. Was it noisy? Yes. But folks, that's what democracy is all about. And what you had here is a very eclectic group of people who were compassionate and idealistic. That sign, I think, sums it up. Another world is possible. The people who came here, from my perspective, were about freedom and justice and equality and fairness for all, not some. Perhaps when the historians and the journalists write about Occupy Wall Street, September 17, 2011, et al., it was the first time, although there were historians and economic people who wrote and studies that were on the shelves about income inequality. This was the first time it became mainstream. It was the first time when people framed the issue 99%ers versus the 1%ers. The argument was very clear, and it reverberated throughout not only New York, but America and the world. It was about, wait a minute, how can you have a constitutional democratic government when in fact 1% owns most of the wealth? How did that happen? And how do we ameliorate that? What was nice about Occupy, it was pure. People were not doing it as stepping stones for political office. But what were the principles and values? Freedom. Freedom of speech. To get up here without mics and have a mic talk back and people say what they believed in their heart and in their brain. Freedom of the press, especially in the Trump era today, where fake press, we need a free press. Freedom to protest. Unfortunately, I get here this morning, and sure enough, we got cops at different places. There's no need for those cops here. This is a peaceful protest. But they stereotype us. They are threatened by us. Why are they threatened by us? We believe in democratic principles. But we recognize that people had a right to protest under the First Amendment, and we were going to do it regardless of what the government was trying to do and shut us down. Justice. When the police were abusive, people put a spotlight on it. I remember one particular thing, and I had a personal involvement as a civil rights lawyer. When the government shut it down, think of this. There were hundreds of books in the library here. And what did they do? They took the books and they threw it in garbage trucks. They destroyed books. Historically, if you think about what governments destroyed books, New York City did that back in 2011. We should never forget that. And we went to court and we did prevail. Inequality, perhaps another one of the legacies of Occupy Wall Street. Racial equality, Black Lives Matter. That was part of the theme here. Gender equality, the Me Too movement, it's time today. There was a recognition that women should be treated equally to us guys. That fight goes on too. Sexual preference, that was a fight here too, the LGBT community. And in those movements, whether it's the civil rights movement for race, for the women's movement, I was this weekend up in Seneca Falls, unbelievable, 1848, the women's convention to achieve eventually, years later, in 1920, the right for women to vote. It's incomprehensible to us today that it took that long for women to be given that right to vote. And still, women aren't equal in pay, in government. That has to change too. So the struggle for equality, whether it's income equality, racial, gender, sexual equality, it doesn't happen overnight. It takes a while. Talk to the African-American community. Talk to the LGBT community. Talk to the women's community. So anyone who thinks that Occupy Wall Street is over doesn't understand what movements and social change and political and economic change are about. I stand here today, as Marnie said too, that the spirit of Occupied Wall Street is still alive. It's in here and it's up here. And we, the advocates, the people who believe in freedom, justice, and equality, we're not going to be quiet. We're going to continue to talk, especially in the Trump era. That means we challenge, we object, and where necessary, we resist government policies and practices that are inconsistent what American principles and values are supposed to be about. Read the Declaration of Independence. Read the Constitution. That sets forth the roadmap for how we take on people who abuse our rights. We need to look at the midterm elections. We need to then look at our Constitution and find in the roadmap what you do when you have autocratic government, when you have people in government who are not doing what the Constitution requires and what we the people need and want. Don't give up. Don't give up. I learned when I went south in the 60s in the Southern Civil Rights Movement. I say Southern because America still hasn't had its civil rights movement. It's good to be smart. The most important ingredient is stamina. You got to outlast the opponents. And so, as Dr. King always said, come together in the beloved community, and we shall. Yes, we shall. We shall overcome someday. Thank you. Occupy. The spirit lives on. Thank you all.